When it comes to famous racing icons, the Ford Mustang is revered by enthusiasts all around the world. In Australia, one of our most famous race-winning models has been lovingly restored, but you won't find it lying idle in a museum. As Mark Oastler reports, this car is still actively competing in events like the Muscle Car Masters.
The Ford Mustang is a racing icon around the world. In Australia, Pete Geoghegan's record-breaking 1965 model and Alan Moffat's Boss 302 Trans Am are two of the country's greatest. Thankfully, they've been lovingly restored and preserved by Queensland collector David Bowden for future generations to admire and appreciate.
But there's a third equally famous pony car that's also survived. And this is it. Pete Geoghegan's 1967 Mustang GTA. People often use the term immortal when describing classic cars like this, but in this case, it's most appropriate. You see, as the Mustang celebrates its 40th birthday in 2007, it's still racing.
The 67 Geoghegan Mustang is owned by veteran sports sedan racer Des Wall, who paid $320,000 for it back in 2005. While that may sound like big bickies for a well-used Mustang, its racing heritage is priceless. During five unforgettable seasons, from 1967 to 71, Pete Geoghegan won three Australian Touring Car Championships and set countless lap records on his way to an incredible 89 wins in 144 races, or roughly two wins for every three race starts. After its illustrious career with the Geoghegans, the Mustang was raced as a sports sedan by Bob Gill before being rescued and restored to its former glory by Ross Donnelly. For Des Wall, finally owning this famous muscle car is fulfillment of a childhood dream.
Oh, look, I think it's a piece of Australian racing history. You know, when the car became available for sale, we were keen to try and buy it, and they were very glad we've got it. I was a teenager at Warwick Farm, as something I've told quite a few people. I watched Pete Geoghegan race there many times and I was just in awe of it, and him as a driver.
Des still competes in the car at special historic events like the annual Muscle Car Masters. It's a huge thrill for today's fans to see such a legendary race car still being driven hard and fast like the good old days. A thrill shared by the driver each time he gets behind the wheel.
I never would have envisaged that I would, you know, one day be sitting in this car and on selected events being able to race it. It's a terrific piece of history. It's actually not bad. It's very different to a modern day race car. It moves around quite a bit, but it has got a reasonable amount of grip. It's got good power. The brakes are of the era. You know, you have to be careful of the brakes, but it's a fun car to drive.
It's interesting to look at some of the modifications the Geoghegan crew made to this car to keep it competitive over five seasons. One of the most prominent was this big aluminium scoop at the front of the car here, which fed cold air into the front brakes.
In the engine bay, the engine was never bigger than 5 litres in capacity, a beautiful little 302 Ford small block V8 with this homemade fuel injection system. Look at the amount of fabrication here for the cold air induction, quite incredible. A lot of handiwork on the car. Wheels got bigger in 1970, up to 10 inches in width, and you can see those beautiful guard flares that had to house them so it didn't look like a speedway sedan, but it certainly gave these cars a very broad-shouldered, masculine look. And one little trick at the back of the car, which a lot of people probably aren't aware of. Back in 1969, Alan Moffat turned up with his Trans Am Mustang, which had a big wing on the back. And of course, the Geoghegan said, well, can we have a wing cam? Said no. So the Geoghegan brothers got a bit clever. This is what they did. They called it the boot spoiler. They ran with the boot lid up like this, with a small adjustable brace between these two points. Well, no one knows if it really worked, whether it made the car faster or slower. It could have slowed it down for all they knew. But the point was, it really stirred things up a bit.
To see this famous car still racing, still competitive, is testament to its immortal character. Pete Geoghegan may be gone, but his legend will live on, thanks to Des Wall and his mighty Mustang.
I think people like to see the car, we like to display the car, and we're very keen to race it at selected events. And I think with due caution, I think that's a good thing.